Faith here, and this is the Q&A video. So, get my phone. I took a screenshot of what I wrote down. So, first of all, from Pokecard X, he asked, what is your favorite Pokemon? So, my favorite is Sylveon for, like, the normal Pokemon. And for legendaries, I like Entei, because, like, even in the Japanese and in the English dub, his voice is so cool. Yeah, that's my main reason. And I guess for Sylveon, I like it because, well, it looks pretty. And, well, you need, what is it, max friendship or affection to level up. Okay. Well, it was one of those. So, that's why I like it. So, next one is from YR PokeTuber. Can we do a drawing battle? Well, yeah, we can if you want, but I'm not very good. I'm not sure how we would actually do that, so drop me a comment or DM me on Instagram or use my email below in the description box and we'll go from there. Little Mouse? M-E-V-S. Sorry if I didn't say it right. And so, do you have any pets? Well, I personally don't have any pets. But my sister, luckily her room is all the way upstairs, she has two hamsters, a budgie, does she still have that? Or was it only one hamster and a guinea pig? Well, over the years she's had very many, many things. And like when we used to live in America, I wasn't with the family then, but we used to have two cats, I think. Of course, it doesn't help when one brother is allergic to cats, but there we have it. Well, I think that's because the mom and dad said that the cats lived outside most of the time. It wasn't an indoor cat, so I think that's why they had cats then. But anyway, I have no idea. Last year, we did take care of a little kitten that was like stationed right outside my door, so sometimes when I have to listen to the door to make sure he isn't awake or near the door, because my room has very many breakable things in it and we want little paws to get at them. But obviously we gave the cat to a friend of mine and seems that the cat's doing well and everything. So I've seen a couple pictures. When they compare for like the before and after, the cat's gone very long, like long ways. It looks still pretty, you know, good size, but you know, long ways, not length ways. Do we have any other cats? Oh yes, we've had a dog in the US, but unfortunately, she had to be put down since she chased after a deer and, you know, yeah. That was unfortunate, because she was a very good one. Like, she used to always lick my face to wake me up. Slightly gross, but still. Still very good. Good memories. Let's see, the next one is Gotta Collect Them All. He's written quite a few of them. Okay, so let's go for this one. What's your New Year's resolution? I don't really... YouTube perspective, it'd be nice to reach maybe 500 subs, would be really nice. But that would, I guess that's more of, that could be a New Year's resolution, couldn't it? I have no idea. I don't really pay attention to that. I don't really have one, really. Yeah. So next question of his is, would you rather live where you are or come on over to the USA? Well, I used to live in the US for 8 years, and this is my 16th year here, I think. I mean, we came here on the 3rd of February, 2003, and like, funny story, is that, I'm rambling, but who cares, is that when, like, we came over here, of course, in the U.S., I was in third grade when I left, so we actually only did some of the states for geography. We never did, like, the wide world yet. So, I had no idea where we were. Never heard of Wales. Of course, when my mom said Wales, I was thinking of Pinocchio. I was like, yeah, that's totally ridiculous. But then when I looked out the window of the coach, because obviously I slept most of the way, and I was 8, so I stayed awake that long, and totally bored out of my mind. So I looked out the window of the coach that we was hired to take us home with all our luggage and everything. So I looked out the window, and it was, I guess it might have finished snowing, so then we had like those fir trees nearby. So the first thought when I saw those was Narnia. I mean, I was 8, so eh. But still, something to remember. Though, would I rather live there than here? I don't know. Store-wise and shopping-wise, possibly, the price differences and everything, it is more handy to live over here, though the shipping is killer. But like, for instance, one of the Funko Pops I have back there, I bought from a very nice friend on Instagram, because she lives in the US, and Jay was kind enough to go to Target and get a Pikachu Funko Pop while she was getting some for herself or to sell, whatever. So, just a random promotion. Go check her out, because she's got loads of awesome stuff on her sales page, which is basically just, well, I've got many posts linked to her account anyway, so you just have to check. Okay, I think I kind of answered that. Did I answer that? Don't know. But anywhere, just in general, possible food sucks. Okay, what's your favorite color? Well, I like red. I used to love pink, like any pink. I had like 5 shades of pink in my pencil case at school, and like pink glittery pencil case, pink lunchbox. I got so tired of pink, I don't like it very much anymore. So I like red. Though technically it's a shade, but I like black too. Though this is more of a dark navy blue, this thing. But I like royal blue. I hate blue in general, but I like royal blue. It's very nice. Like very... but this blue's not too bad. It's more like a blackish blue. So it's a dark navy, like, I guess. I'm not very good with color names, honestly. I really don't like orange or yellow, though. Purple's okay. But orange and yellow, I just don't really see the point. Well, there's a point, obviously, but I don't really like them that much for some reason. Okay, so next. Favorite food. Ooh. It's just, like a snackish, well, not a snack, but an ingredient-wise. I love onions. Raw onions. I don't like cooked onions because they don't have that oniony crunch and that tang. I don't know what the word is. That's just onioniness about it. So, I like our raw onions. I don't like purple onions, though. Which, I guess those are red onions. But I like the normal white onions or green onions. Scallions, I guess, is also another word for it, but those are the small onions. So why don't we just call them small onions instead of a different name? I have no idea. But dessert-wise, I love vanilla ice cream. It's just, I like seafood for Chinese bits. I like sweet and pungent chicken. And cashew chicken is very nice too. Whenever Dad's home, he makes all sorts of Chinese dishes, which is very nice. I don't like sweet and sour. That's... I used to be okay when I could eat the pineapples in it, but I can't eat pineapples, so I don't really like it in general. Orange chicken is nice. Lemon chicken's okay. I like plaice and sole. Those are very nice fishes. I like lobster And I don't think I actually had crab before. I've had imitation crab, but not crab. And I like sushi as well. It's gonna be a very long list. So yes, ramen. I love ramen. Mm-hmm. Ramen's good. Hot and spicy. Lovely. I did try that times two salmon hot chicken one. I failed that. I had like maybe 4-5 things, and like my face was completely red. And, like my mouth burning. My throat was burning. And I had ice cream after that. So, yeah. And it didn't make my tummy feel so good. So I decided to stop eating it. Because I don't want anything else wrong with my stomach. That would be good. Considering, yeah. But if you didn't know, if you eat two spicy things, if you probably can't handle it, it actually is damaging. I think I've heard, because it ruins, like, kills the taste buds or something like that, if your body can't handle it. So yeah, I stopped. Which is unfortunate, because it was kind of good. Because I've had that salmon cold ramen version, which even when it's cold, it's blooming hot. Though I like that Curry's extreme hot and spicy noodles. The normal hot and spicy curry noodles don't taste that hot and spicy, like, at all. But that's just to me. But the extreme hot and spicy, I first got that because I actually didn't notice the word extreme on it. So, I still had it. But it isn't as hot and spicy as I thought it would be. And it was great. I do put a tiny bit extra water when I make it because I like drinking the soup. So, yeah. That counts as favorite snack too, right? Because that's also another question. Favorite candy. No, that's a good one. Because I don't eat that much candy. I like gummy bears. I like, because I'm gonna be a mystery boxes. Premium holiday Christmas box that I got from Etsy. I do have that video uploaded, so go check it out. That had a Black Forest gummy selection. Didn't have very many gummies in there. But it was very good. Like, you know, the Haribo gummy bears, kind of like that. I like those. I like Milky Way. I like mint chocolate. Galaxy's okay. Cadbury's just it's okay. But I really like lint chocolates. It's nice and creamy in the middle. Or, well, no, I'm not sure about creamy, but like more of a smooth, yes. It's smooth in the middle. It's very nice. And I like Oreos. Thins. I don't like the normal Oreo cookies that much because it's a bit thin. But the thins, I can just chow them down without realizing I ate the whole thing. Which isn't very good because some of the Oreos, I can't eat very much because it's quite a bit of fiber in it. But, yes, speaking of fiber, I love Pringles. The Texas barbecue flavor Pringles is the best. I'm not really too keen on the hot and spicy Pringles that much, but I like the Texas barbecue flavor. Oh, another snack I like is beef jerky. That is good. Favorite movie? That is a toughie. I mean, there's lots of movies that I like. I don't really have a favorite. Well, I like Disney movies. I like Marvel movies. I like DC movies. I'm just doing a whole selection here. Obviously, I like animated movies. I think, you know, for a long time, Mom was pretty picky on what movies we could get, even though I was like 18 at the time. She didn't like us watching certain things, rated things, so like, even 15 rated movies were a bit iffy for her. So, then she complains about my Barbie movie collection. I mean, I can't watch something older and you complain about something that seems too young for me. Where is the middle ground, exactly? So anyway, that's not good anyway. But yes, I have a Barbie movie collection. I mean, some of it, you know, it's good animation, good music, and very nice. their storyline for some things, and then it's hidden, well not really hidden, but it's got little nice life lessons inside. And, you know, sharing and friendship and, you know, all that type of stuff. So that's, I like, if you haven't noticed before, I like anime, like, a lot. None of my manga books are really in this room, except for the ones that I have not read yet, which are in the two Tesco bags over there from last Christmas. I've been distracted with other things, so I haven't actually got around to going over there to actually watch them. Yeah. And I like Harry Potter movies. This is nice. Twilight's okay. I like the books better than the movies, though. Yeah, it's basically it's anime back there. But I like loads of different anime ones, like Spirited Away is a classic. I like Howl's Moving Castle. I like action slash romance slash comedy type ones. I hate horror, so I just give me the creeps and I get nightmares easy because my imagination runs away with me. I like the crime drama ones, like NCIS. CSI, and well, you know, those type of things. Some of them I'm not really interested in, but some of them are good. My hobby is behind me. I like collecting things. So, here are the pins. This is actually a camera because I can't actually see. I need to get a vlog camera, shouldn't I? Then there's trading cards behind there. I managed to fit most of my trading cards, well not most, because I got loads in the storage room over there, but quite a lot of trading cards I fit under the desk, which is good, because before they were just lying on the floor over there, and yeah. So hopefully for this, I can actually put them on the desk when I sort things. I have loads of bulk of loads of things, so if anybody's interested in buying bulk, I've got some. Just hit me a DM on Instagram, and I'll set you up with, I think I have quite a few, of the at least comments and uncommons and regular rares. I do have other things for sale on my Instagram, which I'm going and my eBay, which I'm going completely off base here, aren't I? Anyway, my other hobby, besides collecting figures and some plushies and pins, I like making scrapbooks of, like, the pack arts from the trading cards. Got a food scrapbook too, for like wrappers and stuff, because I mean, why not, right? Like, if I like it, I sometimes like write little notes saying like whether I like it, to buy it again, or stay clear of it. I mean, I even got like for a little A5 one, I filled the back page of all the labels from all the different sushis I tried. It's Tesco sushi, but still, it makes an interesting decorative piece page. That was really the last question, but he does put .. on here. But do check out those lovely, nice people that bothered to comment asking a question. One of them did comment saying they didn't have a question, so still, hey forever. This was in celebration, well not really, but I only realized after when I was thinking about recording this. So this is my 1,000th, or 1K, video. Of course I didn't realize until after, so I had to not upload some of the videos I already made, because I would have ended up not quite the right number. So, after this video is up, I can finish uploading and scheduling the rest of the videos I already made. I'll have more things put up for sale on my Instagram sales page, which is in the link, the bio. Do you get what I'm saying? You get what I'm saying, don't you? Oh yes, for the hobby thing, I also collect stuffed animals. I name it my zoo, because like, over there I've got a huge dog I got from a gift from somebody, and America, and it's so big, it couldn't really fit in a suitcase. Well, it's not that big, but it was... Well, it's a lot flatter now, because I've been sleeping on it. But it was bigger than... It would take up too much space of the suitcase, so I couldn't put it in a suitcase when I came over to this country. So I used it as a seat cushion for my wheelchair, and I managed to get it to the country on the first flight over. Then, let's see, I've got plenty of other, like, animal things that I've got over time. Let's see, there's one first. Here's one I got from St. Hagen. It's so cute. It's so cheap and so soft. It's like, I can't believe it. Like, years living here. I never actually bought the shape. So, I had to buy a shape. I mean, it was like, for some reason, £10. But that's a gift shop type thing. To kind of charge a lot. So, and I actually have a dolphin and frog I got from one of those fairground carousel game things. Like when we go to different like attractions like SeaWorld or other aquariums or other places like Longleat and stuff, I always get at least one stuffed animal to add to my zoo. Though I'm still needing a few animals though, but I got loads of bears. I mean, bears are more common stuffed animals, you know, so that makes sense to get more bears. But, I mean, though for Christmas, like 2 or 3 Christmases ago, I got this one bear. It takes up half the bed, but it's very comfy, and it's about 120 centimeters long. So, yes, and I've got like a sort of pillow, which is a caro head from Card Captors, and like there's this other huge like mochi pillow, well it's not a pillow, I mean not a pillow, stuffed animal, that was about 40 pounds in the 2017 anime convention. What is 2016? I didn't go last year because I had no one to go with. And I didn't go in the February one because I didn't actually plan to do it. Because I have to plan these things and I'm not going to go with anyone. And I get lost if I go on my own. And I don't like going to places on my own. It makes me uncomfortable. I don't know if you see, I've got really long hair. And like, well, if you're wondering, not that I remember this, I guess. But, story on. This. The reason why I wanted to grow it long is because, well, the original reason is because, two, I like Rapunzel and Ariel, so I was in my princess stage. I guess it's a princess stage, but I still like the Disney princesses. My favorite one is Ariel, that I have a poster up over there. But I like long hair. I mean, you could do this with it, but this is slightly, it's on the thick, heavy side, so I can't really put it up besides in a ponytail. Which I still manage to step on it, which is slightly annoying, and it gets really heavy when it's wet, like really heavy. But yeah, and also, I'm not having my mom cut my hair again, because like, it was like uneven last time she cut it. That was like in year 7 or something. That's like. So. Oh, I'm not answering that. So. Yeah, well, technically, there isn't anything else to say. So, thank you for watching. Like and subscribe for more. Over and out. Oh, side note, I totally forgot, but I also collect some coins and some certain games, whether, well, I do still play some, but I'm like, get distracted and not get around to it. So, like, some games I collect and play are the Tales of series, the Italian series, and some anime ones. Some of the coins I collect is like I've got so far whatever they came out with the Beatrix Potter 50p coins. Some of the Queen Beast coins. And yes, I do have some coins that I do want to sell. So if anyone's interested, do drop me a DM on Instagram. And that is it. So please.